Have you ever wondered how many ads you see each day? Way too many, right? Well, some experts argue that most of us are exposed to up to 10,000 ads every single day. The good news is that you can block ads on Android. Those intrusive, misleading, or even dangerous ads, along with annoying pop-ups that drain your battery life and slow down your Android device. So I'm here to show you how to block ads on Android phone once and for all. As an Android user, you're probably using Google Chrome since it's the default browser, but did you know that you can toggle off some of the ads through Google Chrome settings? So this is a pretty straightforward process. Start with opening your browser, then tap the menu button. It's those three dots right over there. Go to settings, scroll to advanced, click site settings, scroll to content. In here, go ahead and make sure both pop-ups and redirects and intrusive ads are disabled. If your phone is new, chances are those settings are enabled by default, so turn them off. But if you think this is gonna be enough to completely block ads, you're gonna be falling into the same pitfall as I did. Nobody would be asking how to block ads on Android if it were that easy. Truth be told, Chrome just can't deal with all the intrusive ads, pop-ups, and redirects. And that's why I'm using an ad blocker to succeed where Chrome fails. For example, Total Adblock is hands down the most effective Android ad blocker I've used. It managed to completely block ads on Android, and the same goes for any other intrusive pop-up, on-screen ads, trackers, or even annoying ads in games or videos when played on browser. But due to Google's policy against system-wide ad blockers, you're gonna have to sideload it by downloading the .apk file from Total Adblock's website or through a link, and I'm gonna leave it in the description below. So it has a limited free version, but their premium version is pretty affordable. Plus, it comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee for their annual plans, which I found to be totally enough to test Total Adblock out. Oh, one note, in case your phone does not allow sideloaded apps, you might need to change that setting before the installation. Okay, once you have Total Adblock, the world is your oyster, okay? No joke, it blocked all kinds of nuisances nicely for me. And you can see that for yourself on the screen. So I've pitched Total Adblock versus a specialized test, and no page could stop it. In addition to that, content blocking filter has been the most useful feature that I've used. Right, so an opportunity to filter social media annoyances, trackers, and all that separately is great if you like to fine-tune your browsing experience like me. All right, there's just one caveat on the way. Total Adblock is one of the ad blockers that need to generate a special certificate to operate at full capacity. So my concern here is that the process, which you could see on the screen right now, might look like tech wizardry to beginners, but don't worry, just follow these simple steps and you'll be able to set up Total Adblock properly. Okay, that said, I totally get it if you don't want to deal with such complications just to figure out how to block pop-up ads on Android. That's why I've included two VPN options with ad blocker features. For instance, NordVPN Threat Protection Lite for Android is a feature in the NordVPN app that completely blocks malicious websites and intrusive ads. It's available on the Google Play Store as well, so you don't have to sideload it, and it's even labeled as independently tested by Google, which certifies NordVPN's effectiveness. And remember that with a link in the description, you can get a NordVPN discount as well. So the cool part about NordVPN Threat Protection is that it's automatically activated with the VPN connection. So you get the added benefit of encrypting your connection, hiding your IP address, and more. I mean, I've kind of always thought that it's too good to be true, but after running multiple ad blocking tests, NordVPN Threat Protection does get rid of all the ads, even the most annoying websites. Threat Protection comes together with the NordVPN subscription, and you can use one account on 6 devices at once, which is pretty cool. Not as cool as a 30-day money-back guarantee, though. And if you would like to know more about NordVPN itself, just click this link in the top right corner of the video to watch my full NordVPN review. So I'm not quite done explaining how to block ads on Android phones. One more VPN that does a great job at this is Surfshark. So Surfshark's clean web feature blocks ads and trackers and malicious websites and a ton of other annoying pop-ups really efficiently. Hey, don't take my word for it. The testing you can see on the screen proves it. No ad can survive the purge, and it doesn't have to happen once a year either. Similar to threat protection, clean web requires a VPN connection, so you're gonna get all the benefits of Surfshark VPN while browsing. But I compared its performance to NordVPN, and in my experience, Surfshark is a more lightweight option. This is a serious point to keep in mind if you have an older device. Surfshark will affect its performance much less in comparison. So you can get Surfshark the same way as NordVPN through the Google Play Store. And unlike NordVPN, it has no device limits. So you can share one account with like any number of people. So just to sum it all up, Surfshark is one of the most affordable providers I've tested. It's just a good value, especially since there's a 30-day money-back guarantee to thoroughly test it out in 30 days. So if you're looking for a reliable ad blocker for Android, these are three options I personally recommend. Total Adblock is the most effective, and it's perfect if you don't want to use a VPN to block ads. However, NordVPN Threat Protection and Surfshark Clean Web are great options if you want to block ads on your device and have added value as well. So please tell me your thoughts and tell me, are you using an ad blocker on your Android device? Let me know in the comments down below. And while you're there, try not to miss that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.